Ladies and gentlemen, Yogi Adityanath is a man with a reputation. And U-turns, as we know, are really not his style. Then why has he made two U-turns today is a question that has got everyone talking, not just in Uttar Pradesh, where he has ruled for 7 years, but also in the larger right-wing universe that sees him as the next Prime Minister of India. Let's start with the bulldozers, because the Chief Minister is particularly proud of being called the Bulldozer Baba. The Chief Minister, who has been trying to clean up the Kukrail River in Lucknow from encroachment, has suddenly put the brakes on the project. After 1,200 illegal houses, perhaps more, were demolished in Akbar Nagar, Pant Nagar, that was once again built on encroached land, was supposed to be next. Now, the Yogi Sarkar, which often remains firm and unfazed, has put a brake on their bulldozers. The protests in Akbar Nagar fell on deaf ears, but the pressure from Pant Nagar has worked. Today, Yogi Adityanath assured residents from Pant Nagar that their homes that had been marked for demolition with the Red Cross will not be touched. There was another U-turn coming, one that was to reform education and make teachers who come late to school fall in line. It was a good reform, it was a good idea. But as expected, there were major protests by teachers who called the government's order impractical. In fact, so fierce was the protest that the government had to put the order on hold. The Yogi Sarkar is now saying that a panel will be set up to convince the teachers to come on time. Now, what is significant is the timing of these two U-turns, because this is coming days after Yogi Adityanath, who's ruled Uttar Pradesh for 7 years, said that it was overconfidence in the Lok Sabha elections that hurt the BJP's numbers. He probably doesn't want that repeated in 2027 when Uttar Pradesh votes for an assembly and a chief minister. Now, fact is that overconfidence actually did cost the BJP votes. From 62, the party came down to just 33 Lok Sabha seats in the state. And with the bi-polls round the corner and assembly elections in 2027, Yogi is in low mood to face another drubbing, which might as well end Yogi Raj in the key state of Uttar Pradesh. So has the Lok Sabha har in Uttar Pradesh humbled the bulldozer Baba? I'm asking this question to my guest tonight, Sanjay Chaudhary, spokesperson of the UP BJP. Shantanu Gupta is an author, and Faizan Kidwai is spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. Dolly Sharma is joining us from the Congress Party. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and thank you very much for joining us on the broadcast. I think it's only fitting and fair to start with Sanjay Chaudhary, who's spokesperson of the UP BJP. Sanjay ji, kya ho gaya? Akbar Nagar mein to bulldozer chal gaye, lekin Pant Nagar mein ruk kyun gaye?
देखिए, अकबर नगर और पंत नगर ये कुकरेल नदी के किनारे पर बने हुए इलाके हैं, लेकिन अकबर नगर में जो उसका कैचमेंट एरिया है इस कुकरेल नदी का, जो पूरे गंगा सफाई अभियान के में इस नदी को भी शामिल किया गया है, इसको लेकर इसके आसपास जो इलाके थे उसको सरकार ने खाली कराने की बात की थी, लेकिन लोग कोर्ट चले गए। हाई कोर्ट और सुप्रीम कोर्ट होते हुए डिसीजन उनके खिलाफ गया और सरकार ने जो इसकी हदबंदी की थी उसके आधार पर इसको खाली कराया। आगे का जो एरिया है वो उतनी जितनी जमीन सरकार को चाहिए उससे ज्यादा कुछ निशान लगा दिए गए थे और सरकार को के पास जब लोग गए कि जितना एरिया इसमें डिफाइंड है उससे ज्यादा कुछ लोगों ने इसमें निशान लगा दिए हैं, तो सरकार ने जो अधिकारी हैं उनसे बात करते हुए, अधिकारियों पर निर्देश देते हुए और जिन अधिकारियों ने उस एरिया से आगे जाके निशानदेही की है उनके खिलाफ भी प्रभावी कार्रवाई करते हुए इस अभियान को रोक दिया है और पहले भी जिन इलाकों को खाली कराया था उन इलाके में रहने वाले लोगों को पूरी व्यवस्था के साथ उनको प्रधानमंत्री आवास देते हुए, वहां गैस देते हुए, वहां उनके लिए बेहतर व्यवस्था करते हुए उन्हें विस्थापित किया है और यहाँ भी अगर कोई ऐसी जरूरत पड़ेगी तो सरकार उनको मुआवजा देकर वहां से हटाएगी। हाँ। ये आज के जो निर्णय हुआ है उसमें शामिल है, तो दोनों निर्णय एक जैसे हैं, इसमें कोई बदलाव की बात।
Okay, Faizan Kidwai, would you want to come in here and respond to what the BJP spokesperson is saying? He's saying it was the officials who were actually at fault. They are the ones who on an overdrive that marked houses which need not be demolished, and that is why the brakes have been put on the bulldozer. There is, you know, there is no loss of confidence as far as the Yogi government is concerned. There is no Hindu-Muslim here. It's simply that.
See, if Yogi Adityanath doesn't know what his bureaucrats are doing, then he should step down immediately. That just goes on to prove that he's not only incompetent, but he's also lost. Because after the drubbing these people got in the Lok Sabha elections, I can understand that Mr. Yogi Adityanath's dream of being in line, second in line, to become the prime ministerial candidate for Bharatiya Janata Party, that has been shattered. And I heard today the deputy CM of UP has met the home minister in Delhi. So there's a chatter that Mr. Adityanath might be removed from the post of chief minister. So maybe he's very rattled and confused. See, I just want to ask the Bharatiya Janata Party spokesperson what right you had to displace 1,800 people. They have been living on this land for decades. They have proper papers. They have registry with them. And if you wanted to displace them, why didn't you come up with a rehabilitation plan first? Why didn't you made a committee which would have gone there, spoken to the residents and made sure that their lives are not shattered the way they are today? Shreya, the unfortunate situation in Uttar Pradesh is that Mr. Adityanath, he thinks he is a dictator. He's a ruler. He's here to rule rather than serve. And this is the unfortunate situation Uttar Pradesh is in. But Samajwadi Party and the opposition, we are raising our voices, and the people of Uttar Pradesh are raising their voices. See, sir, Bharatiya Janata Party saab, aap 62
dictators don't take U-turns, huh?
Dictators do take U-turns.
They do.
You remember what happened in the three farm laws? Mr. Modi was forced by the farmers of India and the international community that he had to take back these three farm laws. Okay. So from these are different kind of dictators. They have Nitish Kumar with them, so they somewhat like the U-turn now. So Mr. Modi got so scared of he saw the real power of the people of India. So he eventually had to take the farmers back, and Yogi had to take back these two laws that he passed for the teachers and as well as for
the I'm
residents.
Just getting in Shantanu Gupta. Okay, I'm getting in Shantanu Gupta, who's an author who's written a biography on Yogi Adityanath. Shantanu, is this a sign of Yogi Adityanath getting jittery about what has happened in the Lok Sabha elections and the elections that are to come in 2027? I ask you this for a simple reason. If you look at both decisions on which a U-turn has happened, they're actually not bad ideas. The fact is that Kukrail used to be a beautiful nadi. Now it is a nala. And if you want to clear the nadi of encroachment, and if you want to beautify it, and if that takes demolition, there is nothing wrong with it. But why has that bulldozer action stopped under pressure? Second, the teachers. I mean, how can you fault the government for asking school teachers to show up on time? They protest, it's fine. Let them protest. The fact is, you're the government and you need to set things right. Yet, on the second order as well, a U-turn has been taken. Is this a sign of nervousness?
I think, first of all, let me keep the facts right. The bulldozer action has not stopped in UP, right? In last 15 days, multiple places, bulldozer did action. And I'll quote you example. In Moradabad, multiple properties which were illegal on illegal land, just 15 days back, like I'm not telling you like a month old story. And a resort of Azam Khan, which was again built in Rampur on illegal land, are being taken off. So bulldozer action perfectly on. You know, in last 7 years, property worth rupees 3,000 crore rupees is confiscated.
I'm talking about Panthnagar and Lucknow.
Yeah. So I'm saying you have to take the totality. If you want to do a debate in Panthnagar, then that's a very narrow debate. I'm saying here, Yogi Adityanath government found that some zealous officers have wrongly marked some of the houses which might not have the improper paper. So he said, okay, let's wait, let's check it and we'll review it. Just halt it for some time. So what I'm seeing in multiple news channels, a bulldozer action is stopped. Bulldozer ruk gaya, Baba ka bulldozer ruk gaya. Bulldozer action happening. Today, bulldozer acted in multiple places in UP. UP is 75 districts. Bulldozer action happened today in multiple places, Moradabad, Rampur, Eastern UP, Western UP, that's on, right? So just let's use our brains of statistics. With one case, let's not create a hawa out of it. Second, on the school thing, right? Is what happens in the school phenomena in UP is amazing. What happened in Mission Kayakal, what happened in Mission Nippon is amazing in UP. And this app has 12 modules. It has an MDM module. It has a teacher application module, like the leave application, teacher attendance module. Only the digital application of attendance is being reviewed for 2 months, and all the Shikshak Sanghs are being called. So it just paused for some time, right? And as you rightly said, 1 crore, okay. Two crore children go to these schools. There are 1.5 lakh schools, 2 crore children, and 70% of children are SC, ST, OBC children. And Akhilesh Yadav doesn't want the teacher attendance to be checked.
So you are saying...
marked out. So I think this will come sooner or later.
Okay. So you are saying there are no rollbacks today?
Any big reform takes time.
Okay. So essentially your argument is that there are no U-turns by Yogi Adityanath today.
They're not.
All that has happened is a pause, right? So you're saying all that has happened is a pause. Let me get in Dolly Sharma from the Congress party. Dolly, do you agree with what is being said by Shantanu?
No, I don't agree to Shantanu ji, because I was listening to him, and last debate also we were together. So I was just, what I saw him, a BJP spokesperson in Shantanu, because he speaks one-sidedly completely. We've never seen Yogi Adityanath taking U-turn when it comes to bulldozer. This is the first time in Uttar Pradesh what we are watching. And this is after the statements, continuous statements by the BJP leaders and the allies, BJP allies. Like, for example, Sanjay Nishad said that how we will be win if we demolish people's houses by using bulldozers. This is the statement made by his ally, Sanjay Nishad, who is a minister in the BJP government. So these are, and many other statements, like he was talking about the bureaucrats. Let me just tell you the statement of one of the, BJP former cabinet minister. He said, I have never seen such a corruption in my 42 years of political life. I could neither imagine nor see such corruption in police station. This is really unimaginable. This is what is being, this is the statement made by Moti Singh. And another BJP leader, who's an MLA, he said the party is in a very weak position at present. If the central leadership does not take big decisions in time, it will be difficult to form a government in 2027 elections. And also the statement of Keshav Prasad Maurya, ki sarkar se bada sangathan hai, aur sangathan bada tha hai aur rahega. And all these things, whatever is happening in the BJP, it's now on the road. Everybody is watching it now. So I think the steps, we've never seen him taking such steps
Sanjay
before.
Chaudhary.
And also when it comes to the teachers.
Chaudhary. Okay, let me just get, I have to wrap because there's a piece of breaking news that is coming in. But Sanjay Chaudhary, I will give you 20 seconds to respond to what Dolly ji is saying. Aisa to nahi, Sanjay ji, ki Panthnagar mein BJP ke bahut वोटर बहुत तादाद है बीजेपी के वोटर्स की पंतनगर में, इसलिए वहां पे तो प्रेशर में आके आप लोगों ने बुलडोजर एक्शन रुकवा दिया. बुलडोजर एक्शन टीचर्स भी वोट बैंक है, उनके भी खिलाफ एक्शन आपने रुकवा दिया, लेकिन अकबर नगर में आपके बुलडोजर बड़े अच्छे से चले थे. कहीं ऐसा तो नहीं है कि आप अपने वोट बैंक को खुश करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि इलेक्शन आ रहा है और खतरा मंडरा रहा है.
देखिए, जिन्हें जमीन की हकीकत नहीं मालूम, मैं तो उस इलाके के बहुत नजदीक रहता हूँ, और ये पंत नगर के साथ साथ जिस आप अकबर नगर की बात कर रही हैं,
संजय जी,
पंत नगर के ही
मैं भी उस इलाके के बहुत नजदीक रहती हूँ,
अवरार नगर है. तो ये जो अवरार नगर है, इसके लोगों को भी बचाया गया है. और आज हमने दिन भर देखा है कैसे मुसलमान बच्चियों ने, मुसलमान लोगों ने योगी आदित्यनाथ जी को बधाई दी है. तो इसमें जो बचा है वो अवरार नगर भी बचा है पंत नगर के साथ, रहीम नगर के साथ. तो मुझे लगता है कि इसको इस नजरिए से देखने की कोई भी जरूरत नहीं है, और एक अच्छे मैनेजमेंट के लिए ये बहुत जरूरी है कि वो अगर इस प्रकार के उसने कोई निर्णय लिए हैं और कोई उसमें की शंका व्यक्त करता है तो उसको ठीक करना चाहिए. और दूसरी बात, उत्तर प्रदेश के जो प्राइमरी स्कूल्स है उसमें बच्चों के नंबर बहुत बढ़ रहे हैं, बड़ी संख्या में बच्चे आ रहे हैं. ये वही है जो गरीब है, पिछड़े हैं, दलित हैं, शोषित हैं, वंचित हैं, इनकी इसमें बच्चों की संख्या तेजी से बढ़ रही है. और स्मार्ट क्लासेस शुरू है, और बहुत बड़ी, मतलब मैं समझता हूँ कि 95% से ज्यादा टीचर्स लगातार आ रहे हैं और बेहतर पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं. और उनमें से अगर किसी को समस्या है तो उस समस्या का समाधान करेंगे और समाधान के आधार पर उत्तर प्रदेश की
ठीक है, बहुत बढ़िया, ठीक ठीक है, वी लीव इट देयर फॉर द मोमेंट. संजय चौधरी थैंक यू वेरी मच, शांतनु गुप्ता थैंक यू, फैजान थैंक यू, एंड डॉली शर्मा थैंक यू. आई डू